sports. It's in the game.
Chasing this rain, it's the reason I'm still in my lane. It's the reason I'm never gonna change my heart in the game.
Clearly crafted mission with crass intentions. You may have given them credit so they can save now. No. This ain't the end and you might as well go and lay down. No. Make way to witness the heights are going, I'm paid down. Whoa. You pray for distance from guys like me, it's too late now. Preparation beats opportunity, no? Being great, that's ambiguity, no? Too much at stake for your foolery, is it though? Keep on hating, it's fuel to me, did you know? What have I done? What are my motives? What am I thinking?
What do you think?
What's to be done? Who needs a motive? I won't be defeated. They don't want to see it. Don't want to believe it. But no one will stop to the most uneven. I'm close to achieving my goals. I'm needing to show them everything that I believe in.
I ain't here to fight, Phil.
I got everything to lose.
Cheat codes, I'm flattered, but I don't need those.
Oh.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Today, we jump right into this new season with an AFC South matchup, as it'll be the Tennessee Titans taking on the Indianapolis Colts. Two teams more than ready to get this one started, and we are underway here on EA Sports. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. Begins with a run by McCaffrey. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A good start. One play, 10 yards.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. To throw, it's Allen. He's going to rifle one deep left side. Oh, and that is incomplete.
Man coverage is certainly a staple of their defense, and it's built for plays like that, forcing that incompletion.
Here's second and 10. They'll run it for the first time with Damian Pierce. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. Got an extra defensive back out there for the Titans now here for third down. Allen gonna throw. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. The Colts send out their punter. As the first drive of the game stalls out, he's on to punt. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. And this will be down just inside the 30-yard line.
Too many more ideal situations in second and two in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
That's ready.
Slot man moves right. He's going to handle it on the touch pass. Oh, that is well read defensively. A great job of setting the edge, and that little touch pass is going to turn into a loss. Second and 14. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And this is caught inside the five. Touchdown, Titans. A big play there with his first career touchdown in his first career game. And the Titans are on the board here first in the season opener. Extra point by York is up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And is up across the 25 and down at the 28. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And Charles, nothing like squaring off with a division opponent, a division rival in week one. Do you like that they are matching up this early, or would you prefer a game like this be a few weeks down the road?
I should like the early matchup for a few reasons, Brandon. First of all, it allows you to see that the entire offseason and know, hey, right out of the gate, we're playing a division game. Second part is it spreads them out a little bit. If you just have them all bunched up at the end of the year, that's not as much fun watching teams try to survive that gauntlet when you do have injuries down the stretch. And last but not least, let's face it, we're TV people. What a great game to sell right out of the gate.
Ball right on the 50-yard line. Here's a second and 7. From midfield, here's Allen. Flush to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. He's got his target. It's caught for a Colts touchdown. As he was shuffling right out of the pocket, you could just tell he was going to take a shot downfield. He had his eyes down there the whole way.
He certainly did. He wasn't taking off to go, right? When he was flush from the pocket, a lot of times you see him, eyes will drop, ball will get tucked, and he takes off, becomes a running back. But as you noted, stayed alive as a passer. Tremendous body control and a pretty good arm there, too.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And he'll elect not to run with it. And a fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25.
Okay, ready?
Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. They were successful last time finding the end zone on their opening drive of the season. And they get another shot here with a 1st and 10.
Great.
They'll start this drive out on the ground. They'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
They'll come up now, 2nd and 4 from the 31. A quick throw complete into the flat out left. And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40. He had the touchdown on the opening drive. Now he's got a 1st down. How about the 1st quarter he's putting together out wide? Pretty impressive.
I think that he likes the fact that we're playing this as a day game. You know, some guys, they respond better in the evenings. For some reason, it builds up. For this guy, day game, and he is off and running. You're exactly right. 100 might be conservative with the start that he's had here in the first quarter.
Yeah, by the numbers, he's on pace for 200-plus right now. Escaping the pressure right. And take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, 1st down.
Partner, the good ones have a clock running in their head, okay, because it says something like this. I've got this many seconds to find a target. After that, I have to tuck it and try and get some yardage on this 1st down snap. He doesn't just get some yards, though. He gets a big gain, and they'll come right back with another 1st and 10.
Spotted at the 45. Here, 2nd down and 7. Hands it off out of the gun. And he's going to get this pretty close to a 1st down at the Colts 39. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Strike 3-3. You yell it. Cypress. Rams, Cypress.
They'll look to throw for it on third and one. He's got his target. That's complete. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. Defense was expecting run, and they're dealt a pass of over 15 yards.
That's the third time on this drive that these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going, and right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
Here we go. Ready?
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. Reach the five. These two teams all tied after one. Second quarter now, Titans in possession of the football as they go to work on a first and goal.
On the set.
Now they'll put a receiver in motion left. And he'll get it here on the touch pass. And he's going to score. It's a Titans touchdown. A 5-yard touchdown. And the Titans have taken the lead. Extra point by York is up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. There's the Titan kick team as they run up and send this one away. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. After that last score we just saw, now 14-7, so a chance to march down the field here, try to tie this football game. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
First and 10, it's Pierce. A nice little juke to the 43, second down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
From the 43, here's second down and 7. They go again with Pierce. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. Indianapolis moving the chains there on a gain of 12. Josh Allen, he says that he wants to continue to perfect executing the run-pass option. Looked pretty good there.
And he's put in the minds of all people trying to defend him that his legs create big plays. So guess who benefits?
His running back.
You no doubt about it, and we just saw it there.
Allen now on first down. And this one is incomplete.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball, but he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
Now a second and 10.
Regular.
On play action, Allen. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And oh, that would go right up incomplete. Nearly an interception in the end zone, probably should have been. Third down coming up.
Well, you've certainly got to be on your toes defensively when you're facing Josh Allen. He can hit you from any angle. He's got arguably the strongest arm in the business, and he uncorks a deep one here, but that one falls incomplete.
To throw on third down, Allen. He's going to let it go again. And this is caught inside the five. Touchdown, Indianapolis. A great effort there. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Colts are within an extra point of tying up this ball game. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And we are tied at 14. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee and they'll start at the 25.
Down.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And right now, we've got a little bit of an offensive masterpiece going on. Both sides moving the football, scoring points. It's almost like somebody put the defense in rookie mode in this one. I mean, we haven't even left the first half, Charles, and we're certainly on pace for a shootout.
An excellent start for both offenses. The fans have to be enjoying this to seeing all these points go up on the board. As a former defender, you know I'm not enjoying this at all. But right now, both these teams just trading haymakers. We'll see if anyone slips up first. Can anyone counter with a nice little jab and get things going in their direction?
Now that after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. Back to throw. Under pressure, and they got to him again. Grant Delpit. He's the one that drops him this go-around, and that pass rush getting strong here. Back-to-back sacks.
Well, that's the second time he's been sacked so far in the first half, and they have designs on having a big year, on going anywhere. They've got to find a way to keep him upright so they can throw the football.
Back-to-back sacks have this place in a frenzy as they line up again, third and long now. He'll look to throw. Looking for his running back, and he's got it. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. A real letdown defensively. That was third and a bundle. But they allow the conversion. And the slot man goes in motion left. They'll get it forward to him on the touch pass. I think the hope is, you know, with a touch pass like that, then maybe you catch the defense off guard, but they were all over that one.
And it is the kind of play that works better against certain defenses. And this clearly was the wrong one to run into. Really nice job getting him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Oh, into the return. And to the 30-yard line, that's where the return stops. Well, he's certainly not been afraid to take some chances downfield. Now, look, it's paid off for him a couple of times. That time, not so fortunate.
And that's where I want to start, what you said. It's paid off a couple of times. So his aggressiveness has been good for his offense for the most part. So he throws an interception there. No one likes that. But I would not rein him back in. The return on investment thus far has been pretty good. Two touchdowns to one interception.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
And they'll go right back to Pierce. And a pretty good run there as he gets seven down to the 33. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. Well, they were handed great starting field position on this drive, but now they face a third and four. Now Allen. Working complete, and he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's well executed there on third down, and I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. McCaffrey running up the middle. And a good game here of 9 from the 19 down to the 10. Now the Colts moving quickly here in the hurry up offense. To the air, Allen. And that one to the right side and incomplete.
So many times we've seen him try to escape the pocket and do something with his legs, but in this case, the pressure was too intense and he made the wise choice to just get rid of the football and make sure no one was going to get it.
They tried the throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. Here's Allen. He's got his running back out of the backfield. And the Colts are going to have a first and goal coming up as they find a way to convert there on 3rd and 1. Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on 3rd and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
Pierce is not going to get back to the line of scrimmage as they'll tackle him at the 3. Now the Colts going to burn the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number 2. So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, 2nd and goal. Now they'll send a tight end in motion left. McCaffrey going to be hit and met at the line of scrimmage. They get him down at the 3. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on 3rd and goal. 2 straight shots on the ground. Now on 3rd, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think the 2nd down is the time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being 4-down territory.
Now the Colts will use their 3rd and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. A field goal would break the tie, but look at this. Instead, they're going to go for it on 4th and goal.
Alert!
Throwing now is Allen. And that is caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Christian McCaffrey. Career touchdown number 136. Tying in with Marshall Faulk for 7th on the all-time list. And the Colts have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. Here's Gay now to add the extra point. It's up and good, and that will make the score 21-14. So just 8 ticks remaining here in the first half as they'll kick this one away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25.
Ready.
Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. And with 8 seconds on the clock, really not a lot of time to try to put anything together. Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And a throw right sideline is complete. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit.
Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
He's going to air one out. And incomplete on the deep ball. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. And the half will begin with a touchback. Set to begin the drive. This offense, Charles, had a strong first half throwing the football, at least in terms of yardage, but that hasn't translated so far on the scoreboard as they begin the third quarter here, trailing and looking for a little momentum.
Yeah, you're right about
it. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. A big play that time for the Titans. 42 yards. They'll look to throw here on first down. Eluding the pressure right. And that'll be off the mark, too far out in front, and it's incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
Right. Trouble, 38.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Through the middle of the field, and it's a Titans touchdown. A great play there. Already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Titans come right out of the locker room and score here in the opening minute of the third quarter. Extra point by York is up and good. And we are tied at 21. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. Their halftime lead now evaporated. We're back to level following that touchdown a moment ago.
And that shouldn't change the mindset a whole lot from an offensive perspective because they already knew this was going to be a hard-fought game. Now they just need to go out, execute their game plan, and keep moving.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Allen looks to throw on second down. That'll be caught by James. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield.
Receivers alive in a play. Never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Pierce takes it straight in. And it's a fumble.
Oh, one of the linemen on the other side has got it.
And they will set up shop at their own 41-yard line.
And now after coughing up the football, serious concerns on that sideline. Their defense surrenders the tying touchdown to start the third quarter, and now the offense follows that up by committing the turnover.
And I think you're sensing the exact same thing that I'm sensing, that the energy, much different here in the second half. We talk about it a lot, but you can feel it kind of rippling through the stadium, and it's affecting the players.
Ready?
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he's going to be taken to the ground right there at the 35-yard line. And now they're in the hurry up.
Ball's red. You yellow. Ready?
They'll look to throw now on first down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line.
13 yards as they've got the connection working. His second catch in a row, first down.
Set, ready. Hey, go steal.
Oh, they're going to run a little pop pass here.
And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds.
Let's go now.
2 yards to go, second down.
Black open.
Again, he'll drop to throw. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete.
And the Titans are going to have a first and goal as he's taken down at about the 8-yard line.
Steel, black, red, yellow, right, right, ready.
They'll look to throw again. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he is out of bounds here. A gain of 7 that time. Second goal.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
That's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tennessee. A great effort there. There to make the grab.
And the Titans have scored again in this third quarter, this time to move out in front. Extra point by York is up and good.
And they will take a 7-point lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Indy offense at the line and set to go.
Last time out, they had the fumble. That led to the touchdown. Not a great look on either side of the ball as the defense gave up the points to Charles, but they've got to take care of the...
This is caught at the 20. Touchdown, Colts. A big play there. With now 3 week one touchdowns.
And the Colts are an extra point away now from tying this ball game.
It's been quite the game for him individually. A trio of touchdown catches now.
So pick a route, any route. Whatever you want him to run, he's going to do it and do it well and end up in the end zone. This has really been fun to watch.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And we are all tied at 28. So right back to square one, tied at 28 as he kicks it away.
And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
Here we go.
Tennessee offense about set and ready to go.
And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
On second down, they'll run it here. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down. And they're going to speed things up here.
1-10.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 46 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
They go play action here on first down. Short pass caught by Henry. And a run past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. 11 yards there, just like last play.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
Now from Colts territory, here's a first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Now back to throw. He's going to hit his man in the backfield, complete. And he's taken down inside the 30. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
Quick hitter here, it's complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. We are through 3 quarters here on NFL Kickoff Weekend. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Just week 1, but already plenty of intrigue with the games going on, and this one no different as we come up on a first and 10.
Steal! Check steal! Next!
And now a give, but this is going to be a reverse. And that one going to be slowed up before it could really get going. Good work defensively to read the trickery and make the stop.
43 rail, rail green. Ball red. Ready?
Second and 9 now. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. 9th play coming up here on this drive. This is 3rd and a yard. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. And he'll get it here on the jet sweep. Call a no gain that time, and they're going to be left looking up at a 4th and 1. But defensively, they have that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion, and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
Come on,
tie game, 4th quarter, and they're going for this thing on 4th down. Going quickly out to the right side, but he will not get away. He stopped short of the marker.
The Titans try it, but ultimately they fail on fourth down. And this 10-play drive winds up yielding nothing. So they pass on the chance to kick the go-ahead field goal, and that may be one they're going to regret big time.
And I think the head coach is going to have some splaining to do,
yeah.
Right? Because in this situation, you kick the field goal to give yourself that chance at victory. By going for it, maybe you're saying you don't trust your field goal kicker, or maybe he knows something we don't. Maybe the kicker's hurt. So there'll be a lot of questions in the post-game press conference.
Makes the rest of this fourth quarter and the rest of this game very interesting. And brought down, but not before reaching the 25. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Back to the ground on first, it's McCaffrey. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. Second down, here's Allen. And this is going to be intercepted. He's on his way. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. York on now for the extra point. It's up and good, and they jump back ahead, 35-28. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And can they regroup? That's the question. The pick six hurt, no doubt, but this is still a one-score game here in the fourth.
56.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Working out of the shotgun, here's Allen. James has got it, complete. And out across midfield, down to the 45. That one good for 26 and a first down. And this one out quickly to James. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Here's second and a yard. Throw left side complete. That's James. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Colts in possession of the football as we get you reset. Plenty of time. All three timeouts still remain. Here's first and 10 now. Here's Allen. Open man, there's Darrell Washington. And brought down about the corner inside the 25. Now Allen. Pierce gets this one running right. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. Here comes second down. Looking left side of this guy there. That's James. And he's going to get out of bounds with the first down. So that's going to double their pleasure for sure. They get the first and save a timeout.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
Here we go. First and goal. To throw is Allen. Throw left side complete. That's James. Umpire threw the flag, usually always indicates holding, and that's what we've got.
And you know, depending on their positioning, where you are on the field, the umpires get different responsibilities, but always, always making sure no one's holding.
Allen. Firing quickly, but
certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in a huddle, so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
Nice, well-coached, a team that understands what's going on. They still have time to work the middle of the field as they just did there.
Boy, just a gigantic play here, both sides. This is third and inches. Throwing, and yes, he's in the end zone. So they get the late score they needed, and now the extra point can tie this thing up in the final minute. Gay is on for the point after. And no sweat, he puts it through, and we are tied here in the fourth. Season this has been back and forth, all tied fourth quarter as the kick is away here. And a fair catch taken. No time will come off the clock. And they will begin this critical drive at the 25-yard line. Here's first and 10. They'll look to throw here. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they're saying it's incomplete. The way he's throwing the football today, almost a surprise when he doesn't complete a pass like happened there, but he needs a few more to get his guys downfield.
Well, the way he's throwing it leads him to believe that he's going to get those completions, and that means the guys going out for passes, they'll run even harder because they expect it as well.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. There's that man again. It's complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play. Two timeouts still available in this final minute. It's first and 10 now. Oh, look at this. It's intercepted. And the Colts are going to take over at their own 28-yard line. Well, we say it often, Charles, but not all interceptions are created equally, and that is a big one here in a tie ball game in the fourth quarter.
And, Brandon, when games are this close, it usually comes down to the team making the fewest mistakes, and that was one of our mantras back at Tennessee. Coach Major say all the time, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. You've got to cut those down to give yourself an opportunity.
The Indy offense at the line and set to go. Well, partner, here it is. They've got the chance to win the game. You'd have to think they need to get it near the opposite 40 to have a chance to kick a game-winning field goal. We'll see what they can do.
And you're right about that, because if we look at it in macro, that's what it looks like. But I think in micro, the head coach has already asked the special teams coach, what is he feeling? What does he think? Where does he want the football? What's the yard line we have to get? And he's already relayed that to his quarterback and his offense. They know what the goal is. Now the key, can they get there?
They'll try again here. Second and 10.
Alert!
Now Allen. Has his man. That's James.
They'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. A decent run there following the display of quick feet down just inside the 45. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 14 seconds to go in the game. Here comes second down at 5. Throwing is Allen. Airs this out for Matthews. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
That's taking a big risk at this late stage. They're not thinking field goal, though. They wanted to leave no doubt on that one. So they took the shot at the end zone, but it winds up incomplete.
And this one is right down the middle. Charles, even as long field goals become more and more common, this is still a very rarefied air. Only just over 20 field goals have been kicked from 60 yards or further, and you can add his name to the list now.
And as calm as he tried to present himself, there's no doubt there were some nerves as he lined up to attempt that kick. But once the ball was snapped, he just swept the leg, and boom, over the crossbar.
This is first and 10. And now we'll get a timeout here. They're able to stop it with 1 second to go in this game. Here's first down. One final shot. They'll look to throw. And that's caught inside the 35. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30. Now, this was not just the opener of a brand new season, but this was a division game here in week one. And to come through with a 1-0 start against a division opponent gives you a little something extra heading forward for the rest of the season.
Yeah, let's pile it all into one game, right? Opening the season and you open within the division. You knew the motivation was going to be there on both sidelines. One just executed better and earned the win.
So for the Colts, it wasn't always pretty, but they do eke out the week one victory here by a